Hello everyone, so this is my own creation of the Jango Fett Slave 1 897, and I will show you what I've done and how you can do it too. So yeah, let's show it. So of course we have little Boba here and Jango in the cockpit, and as you can see I have changed several tiles to match the color pattern of Jango Slave 1, and I've specifically chosen this set because it's much easier to transform into Jango Slave 1. If you choose the newer model, maybe look nicer, but yeah, those tiles and those big tiles are pretty hard to find in this dark blue. So I think they don't even exist in dark blue in the newer model. So I've chosen this set. Yeah, and this was pretty easy. You just need like 14 of those large dark blue tiles. And some light bluish gray tiles, like these wedges. And yeah, those came with stickers. So I've ordered like, yeah, 3 or 4 Bricklink orders, and yeah, I didn't found those in light bluish gray, so I got them with stickers, and I think it even looks nice with those stickers. I know it's just gray in the original Jango version in Attack of the Clones, but this is the right color, so maybe I keep them, maybe I tear them off, I don't know. So yeah, for the moment I'll have these stickers and it's okay for me. Yeah, so this plate was dark green in the original Boba Slave 1, and of course this has to be gray. From the pictures of the original Jango Slave 1, I wasn't sure if it's like light gray or dark gray. I've chosen dark bluish gray, so this looks fine. I guess the original one has two colors here in this area. Those two blue bricks, they have to be gray, but I didn't found any bricks in this color. So yeah, I'll keep them blue. Maybe I will change them to dark bluish gray. Light bluish gray unfortunately doesn't exist. So yeah, I'm not sure. So this area you can leave green. Also this round thing is green in the original one, so you can leave it as it is. I've changed these things. They were like grill tiles and in this color, in sand. But yeah, I wanted to give a yellowish touch because this matches more like Jango's version. But you can keep it as it is because it's already good, I think. Yeah, here's yellow here, and this tile. And those, I think, are pretty important to get the look right. It's maybe a little too big, but yeah, it's the only thing you can change, I guess. So it's okay for me. I guess it's cool. And yeah, so under the cockpit, under the glass, here are green, this green round thing and a yellow stripe. But here is no space to put a yellow stripe, so I put it under the windows, and I think that's pretty good. And here is the yellow stripe in the original one. Yeah, so this big area must be dark blue, and here we have a dark bluish gray stripe, and that's like the film version of Jango's Slave 1. And that's pretty much all I've changed. So I have a look. Yeah, like underneath here there were green tiles. I changed them to light bluish gray Also the slopes, they were brown, I think. They were also changed. And yes, that's Django's slave one, of course, with Django in the cockpit. And I think it looks pretty good in this color. I already was a fan of Django Slave One, more so as of Boba's, and I think it turned out pretty well, pretty good, and it looks great. So if you want to have a Django Slave One and not the really old one from like 2002, this is a very easy method to change that. I got the model pretty cheap, like 35 euros, and yeah, those tiles, those blue tiles, those were the most parts, and the yellow ones, I think it cost like 20 euros, but 8 euros were shipping, so the tiles were pretty cheap, so you can buy two and make your own version of this awesome ship. And yeah, it's pretty cool. The UCS one is also pretty awesome. If you look at other YouTube videos, it's maybe also easy to change into Django Slave One, but this is definitely the cheapest version you can do with these, with this model 897 from Lego. So yeah, comment below, have fun, and maybe you make your own creation. Thank you.